弟兄姐妹好，平安。
Good afternoon, brothers and sisters. This is a test, I guess.
Well, I'll speak in English, and our brother will translate into Chinese.
我说中英文，我的弟兄会把它翻成中文。
And we're going to look into a very inspiring and crucial topic today.
我们今天要看一个非常令人可以兴奋而且重要的题目。
Well, I try to shorten the title into eternal glory in knowing Jesus Christ.
我试着把抬头做得短一点，就是在因着认识耶稣基督而有的永远的荣耀。
It's really difficult to give the title to today's sermon, but that's the shortest I can summarize it.
我已经尽力把它说得最短了。
So I'm going to begin by proclaiming one of the most fundamental or basic Bible verse that all of you are very familiar with.
我这边要跟大家讲一个大家都很熟悉的经文。
It's John chapter 3 verse 16.
约翰福音三章十六节。
I'm going to proclaim it and then we're going to pray.
我要宣告，我们一起祷告。
For God so loved the world,
神爱世人
that he gave his only begotten son,
甚至将他的独生爱子
That whoever believes in him will not perish, but have everlasting life.
赐给我们，以至于一切信他人不至灭亡，反得永生。
Father, thank you for your begotten Son, Jesus Christ.
主要为你的儿子耶稣基督感谢你。
Thank you that through him we have the mystery and the reality of everlasting life.
因着他，我们可以领受这个永远的爱。
We thank you for this substance and the glory of eternal life.
我们真是为了这个永远的荣耀来感谢赞美你。
Father, we thank you.
父，我们谢谢你。
Reveal that glory to us today.
今天把那个荣耀跟我们彰显。
Not only.In our head, in our mind, in our knowledge,
不单单是在我们的心、我们的意志、理解上面
but in our experience,
而在我们的领受跟经历上
that we know and we know of this glory on a daily basis.
我们真能够认识、能够看见这样的荣耀在我们每一天的生活当中
In Jesus' name,
奉耶稣基督的名祷告
Amen.So today we want to explore the glory of eternal life.
我们今天要谈永生的荣耀。
But John 3:16 make it very clear. In Christ, in Jesus Christ, we can avoid perishing.
约翰福音三章十六节讲得非常的清楚。因着耶稣，我们可以不致灭亡。
Every one of us want that. Amen?
我们都要，对不对？
We don't want perishing.
我们都不要灭亡。
We don't want death.
我们不要死亡。
We don't want destruction.
我们不要毁灭。
We don't want hell.
我们不要地狱。
And then we want eternal life.
而我们要永生。
Amen?
Amen?
How many of you are not sure?
你不太确定吗？
Well, you can be sure after you accept Jesus today again.
如果你今天再度接受耶稣，
No, I am not kidding. This is a very serious subject matter.
我不是开玩笑，这是一个非常重要的事情。
Now, why am I bringing up something so basic to a church that is so advanced in pursuing the Lord?
为什么在一个今天牧主这么一个在追求牧主这么火热的教会当中，我需要提一个这么基本的概念？
We know we do not want to perish.
我们知道我们不要灭亡。
We know that in Christ we will have eternal life.
我们知道我们在耶稣里面我们会有永生。
But we actually put very little thought to what eternal life is all about.
但是我们不太明白到底永生是什么。
Actually, if you think much about it and you meditate upon eternal life, there is both this greatness, exhilaration, as well as trembling.
如果你真的静下心来仔细思考永生是什么意思，会让你颤抖战惊的。
The exciting part is that we are never going to die and we're going to have a resurrected body.
那个令人兴奋的部分是我们不致灭亡，而且我们会有一个永生复活的身体。
Amen.
Amen.
No COVID 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, nothing will touch that body.
没有 COVID 19, 20, 21, 22, 没有一个东西可以碰触我们的身体。
No more sickness.
不再有疾病。
No more sorrows.
不再有悲伤。
No more sin plaguing our emotion and our body.
不再有那些情感好像掌管我们的身体。
Amen.
Amen.
But then, once we have that eternal existence,
一旦我们有这个永生的存在
that is forever and ever and ever and ever and never ends,
那就是一直不断、不断、不断、永远的存在
Now what?
然后呢
What do you do with forever and ever and ever? You can never disappear.
当你永远不会再不见的时候，你要做什么
？You know, sometimes you watch some kind of a drama or movie. You know, when somebody gets some superpower and they won't die, they watch the people beside them dying all the time. They cannot die, right?
我们有些时候看到一些电影、小说描述有一些超人，他不会死，他们身边人都死掉了。
Everybody's growing old and die. They keep living on, and they feel miserable.
他们身边的人一个一个离开死亡，但他们就不会死，这很可怜的。
Because they make friends and their friends grow old and die, and then they make friends again. You know, like they never die.
因为他所有的朋友都死了，他还在那边。
This kind of scenario causes us to think, like if you live on forever and ever, is it really all that exciting?
所以让我们想想看，真的一直活着让你那么兴奋吗
？When time is no longer a limitation,
当时间不再是个限制。
You have all the time in the world.
你有全世界所有的时间。
There is no limit. You can never finish spending time. You can do everything the slowly, slow motion, and you still will finish.
时间是无限的，你可以用最慢的慢动作，时间也用不完。
There's no hurry up, hurry up.
不再有人说快点，快点，快点。
So what do we do in such an existence?
如果我们真的有这样的一个永远的存在，我们到底要做什么
？Why does God have a plan of such a nature？
神为什么要有这样子特别的计划呢
？And not only He allow us to have eternal life, we picture that. Okay, I will have eternal life, personal salvation.
不单单是我们个人要得到救赎而有一个永生
，But it's not just us individually.
不是我们个人而已。
Revelation 7:14 and 7:9 talks about every tongue, every tribe, every nation standing before the throne.
启示录七章十四、十三节有提到各族、各民、各方都要站在宝座面前。
All the different tribes, the different languages, the diversity of the people are going to live together forever and ever and ever and ever.
各民各族各方超各样语言的都要永远永远的存活。
So right now, if we don't like this, we move on to something else. You know, we can fly to another country, move to another city, and all kinds of things. Or you know, sometimes one generation pass away, another generation come. But in eternal life, everybody is going to be around forever.
我们现在的社会不喜欢，我就搬到另外一个地方。人会死，所以上一代的不见了，下一代就存活继续。但是在一个永生里面，一代一代人都不会死啊。
There is no end，
没有结束。
This is the eternal plan of God，
这是神永生的计划。
That's the trembling part，
这是让我们会战惊的地方。
Are you ready for that？
你准备好了吗
？Because the moment you say yes to Jesus, eternal life begin to bubble inside you, springing up onto everlasting life. We better start practicing right now.
因为当我们接受耶稣基督，我们救主，接受这个永生的时候，这个永生就要成为我们生命的前面的事实。
Eternal life does not begin when we die. Eternal life begin right now, the day we were born again. The Holy Spirit dwell within us.
当我们重生的那日，圣灵在我们里面，我们重生，永生就开始了。
The church on the earth is a microcosm or a picture of community of believers living out eternal life within the confine of space and time.
今天的教会在地上就像是一个将来永生的一个时间跟空间的一个小小的缩影。
So let me point out to you in John chapter 17 verse 3.
我们看约翰福音第十七章第三节。
Let's read that verse.
一起读这段经文。
Because it's straight to the point.
直接直指核心。
Jesus is saying to us, without any hidden agenda, what is the definition and the purpose of eternal life?
在这里，耶稣非常明白地讲，到底什么以及目的永生，关于永生。
Let's read it together.
我们一起读。
One, two, three.
认识独一的真神，并且认识你所差来的耶稣基督，这就是永生。
So this is eternal life, the scripture says.
这张经文定义的非常清楚，这就是永生。
That they may know you.
那一天我们真认识的时候。
The key word is the word know you.
关键字是认识你。
This is not a one-time encounter or acquaintances with someone.
这并不是说我们跟某一个人打招呼，一次性的见面。
This is a process of relationship.
这是一个整个关系的进展，发展进程。
That never ends.
不会停止的关系。
Now to confirm that God really means this,
我们若要确认神是真的是这个意思。
In John 17:24,
我们看一下第十七章二十四节。
Jesus so clearly expressed his desire to the Father.
耶稣在这里非常非常明白地跟父神讲他的心意。
And the scripture says,
经文是这样说的。
Father,
父啊
I desire that they also, whom you have given me,May be with me where I am.
我在哪里，愿你所赐给我的人也同我在那里。
To see my glory.
他们可以看见你所给我的荣耀。
That you have given me because you loved me before the foundation of the world.
因为你在创立世界以前，你已经爱我了。
You see, Jesus did not merely save us from hell.
耶稣不是只把我们从地狱中拯救出来。
Save us from perishing.
把我们从灭亡当中拯救出来。
And put us in this perfect environment called heaven.
把我们拉到一个完美的环境叫天堂。
And just leave us there so that we can float around, be happy forever.
所以我们在那里很开心啊，东晃晃西晃晃很开心，永远永远。
Most of us will have that as our end picture of what eternal life is all about. Escaping hell, going to this happy place called paradise and float around forever.
对我们很也许当中很多的人讲对这个救赎一个很重要的一个图像就是离开地狱到一个天堂乐园去。
So imagine floating around forever.
想想看如果你可以这样漂浮永远的这样漂浮。
Is that very exciting?
很兴奋吗
Well, some of you love that, just floating around forever.
我看当中有些人很喜欢哈。
I don't find that very exciting.
我不觉得它很兴
奋。Especially when there's no end to floating around.
特别是他那个漂浮是没有结束的一天。
But Jesus gave us a very different picture.
但是耶稣在这里给我们一个非常不一样的图像。
He gave us a picture that, Father, I want to tell you what exactly what I'm desiring.
耶稣要跟父神说，父，这是我就是要这个事情这样发生。
In fact, we talk about this before you created in Genesis chapter 1.
父神，你当初跟我提过这，在创立世界以前，我们就谈过这个计划。
Before the foundation of the world, when we were perfectly one in love, we talk about the purpose of this creation.
在创世以前，当你与我完全合一的时候，我们就谈过这个目的了。
We knew there's going to be a fall in the Garden of Eden.
我们知道在伊甸园会有一个堕落。
We knew I have to go.
我知道我需要上十字架。
As the slain lamb.
我需要上十字架，受像一个受代罪的羔羊。
Pay the price for them.
为他们付代价。
So that they will be mine forever.
以至于他们永远都跟我有关系。
That when I save them,
当我拯救他们的时候，
they will be near me.
他们会接近我。
They will behold me.
他们会靠近我。
When they get to know me and behold me, they will be fascinated by me.
当他们真能够高举我、认识我的时候，他们会因我而惊喜。
And their love for me will grow.
他们对我的爱会一直与日加增。
Not only during the time when they were on the earth.
不单单是他们在地上的时候。
When they enter into eternal life, they will have unlimited time to discover who I am.
即使到他们上了天堂，他们会有无穷的时间来真正发现我是谁。
Do you know how confident that statement is?
你知道这样子的一个叙述是多有信心吗？
You know, some of us say, I want to let you know who I am, but just enough so that you like me, not too much so that you don't like me.
你知道有时候我们跟人之间，我们会透露一些我们要让你知道的，所以以至于某一些程度你还会喜欢我，不能让你知道太多。
But Jesus is saying, I am going to remove the time limitation, and so that you can come, behold me, and get to know me, and you have no limit of time.To get to know everything about me. And you know what? The more you know me, the more you will love me.
耶稣在这里是非常有信心的宣告，在一个无穷的时间当中，你可以靠近我，认识我，而怎么样？你会越来越爱我。
That is supreme confidence.
这是超级的有信心。
He is so sure that if we know him, we will love him.
他是如此的确定，如果我们真的认识他，我们会爱他。
But that is not true for every relationship.
但是在我们人跟人之间的关系，很多不是这样
的。Sometimes we have love at first sight. Whoa, I'm so impressed. First impression, awesome.
有些时候我们一见钟情，第一眼看下去太好了。
Within after 3 months, honeymoon is over.
三个月之后蜜月期结束。
After that, I discover too much. I know too much about you now.
之后我发现，我知道太多关于你的事。
Sometimes not that way all the time.
有些时候不总事情不总是这样。
But for Jesus.
但对耶稣,
he is supremely confident
他是如此的有信心,
that he wants to give his people eternal life.
他要给他的人永远的时间,
and that is the thing that will sustain us in eternal happiness and eternal glory.
因为这个永远的时间以至于我们可以对他一个永远的爱跟享受永远的快乐。
In fact,That is the only reason why we can be happy forever.
其实这就是我们可以永远快乐的唯一原因。
Two syllable.
两个音字节。
Jesus.
耶稣。
耶稣。
Jesus.
That is the reason.
这是唯一的理由。
Because the God who is so magnificent has become flesh.In a person by the name of Jesus.
因为耶稣这么伟大的神，道成肉身，取一个名字叫耶稣。
This God who is unknowable.
这个神是不可知的。
Unless he reveals himself, we have no capacity to be able to even comprehend who he is or what he is.
除非他愿意跟我们显现，我们是不可能了解他是谁。
But he was willing to package himself in the form of a person called Jesus, and this Jesus wants to live with us forever and ever.
但他愿意道成肉身成为耶稣，而耶稣愿意跟我们永远的相处。
There is much to be said about that.
这个点有很多可以谈的。
But I want to transition quickly to the concept.In 1 John chapter 4, verse 8,
我们要很快的转换到约翰
一书第四章第八节。John chapter 4, verse 8 is a very simple verse. Say, God is love.
神是爱。
God is love. In other words, he embodied.The meaning and the expression of what love is all about. Love cannot be understood apart from God.
在这里一个很重要的观点，离开了神，你没有办法了解什么是爱。
So, we all know love is a relational word.
我们都知道爱是跟关系有关的。
So, God is a God who is eternally relating in love, in covenantal love.
所以神是一个跟永远与爱有关系，而且是一个立约的爱。
That's why he said in John 17:3.
这是为什么他在约翰福音第十七章第三节说
，This is eternal life.
这就是永生。
Eternal life is eternal knowing.
永生就是永远的认识。
Eternal knowing is eternal relating.
永远的认识就是永远的有关系。
Eternal relating is eternal love.
永远的有关系就会带进永远的爱。
An unbroken covenantal relationship with Jesus.
这是一个不能够毁灭的一个约，与耶稣定的约。
So clearly described in Romans chapter 8, verse 35 to 39.
罗马书35第8章35到39节非常清楚的描述。
Neither death, nor life, nor principality, nor this age, nor the age to come is able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus.
没有一切的苦难、伤害可以分别我们跟耶稣的爱。
And then this favorite wedding verse in 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 13.
哥林多前书有一个非常有名的经节。
First Corinthians chapter 13, verse 13.
十三十三，林前十三章十三节。
Faith, hope, and love. Faith, hope, and love.
信望爱。
In these three.
在信望爱。
Greatest of all is love.
在其中最大的就是爱。
Because love never ends.
因为爱永不止息。
Because God never ceases to exist and relate.
因为神永远不停止存在。
So why does God give us eternal life?
所以神为什么要给我们永生?
Because the width and the length, the depth and the height of His love cannot be fully understood and experienced with the limitation of time.
因为神那个长阔高深的爱是没有办法在有限的时间之内完全被理解的。
There is not enough time in all the universe for him to express his love with her, to us, so he decided to kick time out of the way.
只要有时间的限制，神就没有办法把他的爱完全的彰显，所以他决定把时间这个因素踢掉。
That's not enough time.
不够，时间不够。
1,000 years is not enough time for him to show his love.
1,000年也不够展现他的爱。
For us to understand his love.
以至于让我们可以了解他的爱。
10,000 years.
一万年也不够。
1,000,000 years.
一百万年也不够。
Not even close.
差得远。
Not enough time for us to grasp his love.
有限的时间没有办法让我们理解他的爱。
So he has to give us eternal life.
所以他需要给我们永生。
Because he enjoyed this relationship so much, he never wants it to ever end.
因为他这样的享受这样的关系，以至于他不要这样的关系结束。
So the first thing that we realize is that not only he is supremely confident in who he is.
所以我们首先看到的是，不单单他是对他自己这样的有信心。
But he also liked us that much to the point that he never wants us out of his sight.
第二点就是他如此的爱我们，以至于他不希望我们离开他的眼目。
Never want us to be apart from him.
不要我们离开他。
Can you imagine somebody who likes us that much?
你可以想想有人这样子的爱我吗？
Sometimes if somebody likes us that much, we ask them to cool down a little bit, you know, like.
有些时候人家很爱我们，我们就说你稍微冷静一下。
I need some space.
给我一点空间。
But when you read John 17 verse 20 to 24, he's not talking about space. He's not interested in space.
但是你读约翰福音十七章二三二十四节的时候，你没有看到神要那个空间呢。
He is into I in him, he in me, and all mixed up together into one. There's no space. There's only intimacy, no space.
他在那个在十七章约翰福音十七章提到的，你在我里面，我在你里面，完全没有距离。他就是一个乎亲密关系。
Who is in who? I don't know. At the end, it's all one.
谁在谁里面，最后都是合一。
So we want to explore why God.Love eternal life so much, he wants us to grow in love towards him now onto everlasting life.
所以我们先要了解为什么神要我们要对他的爱要与日的加增，以至于我们可以享受他永远的爱。
So for the second half of this message,
我们接下来这半段的信息，
I'm going to leave you some practical discipleship tools to help you grow in the love of God from today and every day of your life.
我要给大家一些很实用的门训的工具，让你可以在你对神的爱跟认识可以增加。
Actually, Jesus showed that very clearly in the Bible.
事实上，耶稣在圣经当中非常的明显的讲了这些事情。
Let's go to Acts chapter 9.
使徒行传第九章。
This was the account of one of the most prolific writer of the New Testament, the Apostle Paul.
这是新约当中最卓惨的一位作家 保罗所说的
His own conversion
他自己个人的遭遇主的转变的过程
All of us know he was the persecutor of the church
我们都知道他是迫害教会的人
But he has a lot of head knowledge theologically He was a well-trained theologian
他是一个非常受良好训练的神学家
He was convinced he was serving God when he was persecuting the church
他非常确定当他在逼迫教会的时候他是在服侍神
He was so convinced he was doing something for God.
他非常确定他是在为神做事。
So he was actively, zealously serving God.
所以他是非常狂热的服侍神。
He has zeal for doctrinal purity.
他是追求这个教条、教义的纯洁。
So he went on to Damascus in order to purify the religion of Yahweh to kick out all the heretics.
所以他到大马士革的目的就是为了洁净信仰。
On the way to Damascus, we all know he encountered Jesus.
我们都知道他在去大马士革的路上，他遇见了耶稣。
You know, Jesus, after his resurrection, he showed up in many different ways to different people.
你知道在耶稣复活之后，他在许多的地方跟许多的人显现。
On the road to Emmaus,
在去以马忤斯的路上
去 he talked to two people.
他跟两个人说话
They don't even recognize it was him.
他们根本不认识他就是耶稣
Until after, you know, they broke bread and then their heart was like, this is Jesus, fire of the Holy Spirit, you know.
直到他们后来一起用餐才发现哦，好像那个是耶稣啊。
And then he showed up to the apostle near the Sea of Galilee.
他后来在加利利海去见使徒们。
They were fishing out of discouragement.
那些使徒已经改业在钓鱼了。
Sometimes you go to all these waterways near the Bay Area, you see people fishing. Maybe those are good candidates to share the gospel. They might be discouraged. That's why they are fishing.
也许你可以去湾区看有人在钓鱼的，也许那是可以好好分享福音的对象。
Maybe not everyone is like that, but sometimes they need space and they need peace, so they go fishing, right?
不是每一个人了，但是有些去那边的人可能他需要一些空间，需要一些时间呀。
Well, Jesus appeared to them.
耶稣向他们显现。
To have breakfast with them.
跟他们用早餐
and to share many amazing things with them.
跟他们分享了许多很棒的故事。
But when he showed up to the apostle Paul,
但是他当跟他保罗显现的时候
it was a form and an expression that was so unprecedented that it blinded Paul.
那是一个从未有过的现象，以至于他把保罗都搞瞎了。
In English, we call that he didn't hold back his punches.
用英国人来讲说他的这个拳头啊没有收敛就打下去了。
You know, full blast,
全力就打下去了。
Just show himself.
就是把他的能力就彰显了。
Just like the Mount of Transfiguration.
就像在登山变相一样。
He just show his glory and Paul was blinded by that glorious manifestation of Jesus.
当神彰显他的荣耀的时候保罗就看不见了。
And this great learned theologian who understood all the scripture have to ask the most basic question, Who are you, Lord?
以至于这个饱读经书非常熟悉的、非常有知识的神学家要问一个最基本的问题，你是谁？
I guarantee you, Paul memorized all the Hebrew name for Yahweh. He knows everything.
我相信保罗非常清楚希伯来文当中每一个神的名字。
When Paul spoke to the crowd in Jerusalem in Hebrew, they all hated him, but they had to listen because he was so convincing when he spoke in Hebrew.
当保罗在耶路撒冷跟犹太人说话的时候，他们虽然恨他，但是他们得听他，因为他非常清楚关于一切有关神的事情。
But on that day,
但在那一天
，Paul has to come back to the most fundamental.But most important question.
但神在保罗在那一天需要回答一个基本的最基本的问题。
But a question that we can never graduate from.
那个问题是我们永远不能够停止问的。
Who are you, Lord?
你是谁，主
？Sometimes in our relationship with some old friends, or even our family members.Suddenly, they did something that we have never seen before, and we say, "Who are you?" We never say it out loud; we just say it in our heart.
我们在有一些关系当中，我们很熟悉的朋友突然做了一件我们不明白的事情，我们会问，在心里问，有时候不会说出来，你是谁
？Who is this person? I thought I know him for 10 years. Never seen that before.
我认识他十年，没有办法想象他会做这样的事情。
Sometimes it's really good, but sometimes it's really bad. You know?
有些时候可能是好事，
but it's new,
有些时候不好。
It's new, new information.
总之那是新的资讯。
Who are you?
你是谁？
We encountered that a little bit here and there.
我们有时候有这样的经历。
But Paul was really in that moment when he said, "Who are you, Lord?"
但主保罗在那个时候，真就在那个时刻，他要问主，你是谁？
When I came here in August, I expounded on Isaiah chapter 6.
当我八月份来的时候，我提过以赛亚书第六章。
Some of you may be here during that service when Pastor Francis and I were sharing the pulpit.
那个时候 ，Francis 牧师跟我在这边当中，有些人也在。
So in Isaiah chapter 6, verse 1 to 9.
在以赛亚书第六章一到九节。
We saw that Isaiah encountered the Lord, and that encounter was divided into three crucial sequence.
以赛亚在这边遇见神的经历可以分成三个段落。
Verse 1, all the way to verse 3, we saw that Isaiah encountered God, that he knew he was God, but he had never seen God that way before.
一到三节这一个段落说的是他知道也是神但他从来没有见过神是什么样子。
Only 4 throne room accounts in the whole Bible, this is one of them.
在整个圣经当中只有四个段清楚的描述这是其中的一段。
And then from verse 4 onwards, all the way to verse 7, we have him encountering his own condition and his own state.
在四到七节描述的是他认识到被光照自己的景况。
And then verse 7 and 8, he encountered the works of God, the commissioning of God.
在七到八节 他跟神的遭遇、经历这个就是神的差遣。
So during that time, I emphasize that Paul's encounter in Acts chapter 9, when he asked, "Who are you, Lord?" he also went on to ask, "What shall I do for you, Lord?"
在八月份的时候，我曾经跟各位提到，保罗在那一个大马士的遭遇上，他遇到了两个关键的问题：第一个，主你是谁？第二个，我能为你做什么
？Today I'm going to bring in one more passage.
今天我要再带入另外一段经文
，John chapter 14.
约翰福音第十四章
Verse 1 to verse 15 There is a flow there. We don't have time to go into detail, but I'll share with you the main point.
一到十五节我们不会一节一节念但是我把重点跟大家讲
Now Jesus began to talk about his departure.
那耶稣要为他的门徒预备他准备要离开了
Jesus knows that if he starts talking like this, they're going to be very sad.
耶稣非常清楚知道他如果这样子开始讲他们一定会非常的难过
So he's talking about eternal life right now
所以他现在先谈永生
He said I'm going to my father's house
他说我要到我父那里去
I go there to prepare a place for you so we can live together forever
我会在那里为你们预备住处所以我们可以永远在一起
He's speaking as a bridegroom you know that right He's building a house so that he can bring his bride into the father's house
他在这边提的是他要建一个新娘的房以至于把心腹带到天上
心腹要把新娘带进他天父的家 OK
好 Pardon 新郎 Sorry
I was speaking a little fast too So if I go there to prepare a place for you He said I will come again and will take you to heaven
我如果在那边预备好住处会回来把你们再带去
你们给我骗了，我没有跟着经文读。So I did not follow the scripture. The scripture say, "I will take you to myself, not to heaven." That's big different, big, big different.
刚才如果你们都被骗了，这经文没有讲他要把你带到天堂，经文说带到我这里，带到我这边来。
Because local time in California is the afternoon, I have to do this to wake you up a little bit, you know.
因为怕各位有人睡觉用这个来挑战你让你醒过来
So he said I will take you to myself
我会把你带到我这里来
This is John 17:24 Where I am I will bring you near Not to a place To me I want you near
约翰福音十七章二十四节提的就是把你带到我这里来接近我不是带你去一个地方
and just in case you think there was a typo or a mistake or mistranslation in the Bible there's another emphasis to explain that right after myself that where I am you may be also 我在的地方你也在。The next one he says, where I'm going you know, the way you know. Now they are so confused.
接下来他就提到说我所要去的地方你们也知道。他们就非常混淆了。
They all shake their head and say, we don't know what you're talking about. Where are you going?
他说我根本不知道你要去哪里，门徒都搞不清楚。你要去耶路撒冷吗？
Galilee?
加利利吗？
They have no concept of this heavenly new Jerusalem thing.
他们完全没有这个天堂的新耶路撒冷的概念。
Then Jesus went on to say this in verse 6.
耶稣接下来在第六节说，
Because Thomas just said, we do not know where you're going. How can we know the way?
因为多马跟他说主我根本不知道你往哪里去怎么会知道呢
Jesus introduced this very powerful and important truth that we quote all the time.
所以耶稣在这里讲了一个非常有能力的真理我们常常引用
And Jesus said I am the way.
耶稣说我就是道路
It's not a method.
不是个方法
It's not a process.
不是一个过程
It's not a philosophy.
不是一个哲理
It's not a religion.
不是一个宗教
Me.
我就是我
I am the way.
我就是道路
Just follow me.
就是跟着我
Your way is a person.
你的道路是个人
Truth.
真理
You look for truth?
真理
You want to be set free by truth?
你要因真理的自由吗
Me. 耶稣两个字
我就是 Jesus the two words.
I am the truth.
我就是真理
The truth is not a concept.
真理不是个概念
A body of knowledge
那不是个知识
It's a person
是个人
You want life?
你要永生吗
Me
生命吗
I am
就是我
life.
我就是生命
So Jesus is saying If you want the truth If you want to know the way And you want life It's all just me
如果你要真理你要道路你要生命那就是我
So just hang out with me
就是跟我在一起。
Where I am, you will be also.
我在哪里，你要在哪里。
What you are signing up forever is me.
你承诺的就是跟我永远在一起。
And Jesus began to expound further, and then further down, they begin to get confused.
耶稣继续在解释，但是他们更搞不糊涂了。
And then Jesus is verse 10 to verse 11, he began toThat's a good part that for them to show. He began to say that, do you not, verse 10, do you not believe that I am in the Father and the Father is in me? The words that I say to you, I do not speak on my own authority, but the Father who dwells in me does his work. Believe that I am in the Father or the Father is in me, otherwise or else, believe on the accounts of the works themselves.
在这里耶稣从十节到十一节跟他的门徒说我在父里面父在我里面你不信吗我对你们所说的话不是凭着自己说的乃是住在我里面的父做他自己的事你们当信我我在父里面父在我里面即或不信也当因我所做的事信我
So I am trying to reveal who I am to you I am the way I am the truth I am life
我想让你们知道我是谁，我就是那个道路、真理跟生命。
But if you cannot relate to me at that level, let's start with something more rudimentary or fundamental.
如果这样子的讲法你不能够理解，那我们从比较基本的开始好了。
比较外围的 ，something that is more external. Let's start with works. My works. I can heal. I can walk on waters.I can multiply food.
如果你对我的核心你没有办法完全的明白，那你就看我所做的是比较外围的东西。我可以医治，我可以做各式各样的神迹奇事。
Some of you can relate to this.
也许你们当中有一些人可以明白这样的事情。
You live in the Bay Area.
你们都住在这个湾区。
Many of you are in the marketplace.
很多人在职场。
You have a job.
我们有个工作。
You have a business.
我们有自己的生意。
And when you meet somebody in the social function,
当我们在碰到某些人的时候
you shake hand,
我们握手。
And how do you introduce yourself?
你怎么介绍你自己
You introduce your name.
你介绍你的名字。
But that doesn't mean so much. They want to know what you do.
讲个名字还是人家不知道
你。Because then they know how to relate to you.
他们要知道怎么跟你有关系。
They know how to connect you to this person who is related. They know what topic to talk to you. If you are in the technology industry, they talk to you about cooking. It's like what?
他们要知道要跟你谈什么样的话题。如果你是在科技领域，他跟你讲烹饪，这个好像连不太起来。
So they want to know like what is the thing that we can talk about and exchange and fellowship, right? So they ask about your job. What do you do?
所以人会问说你是做哪一行的，以至于我们知道用什么样的话题来跟你谈。
And this is very practical. We want to know our function.
这很实际的，我们要知道他在做什么。
And we find that even when we introduce our friends to other people, we do that too. This is Michael, this is James, this is Chen, and he is a musician. He is a worship leader.
我们常常这样说，我们介绍朋友之间也是这样说，哦，他是个音乐家，他是个敬拜者。
Why do we do that?
我们为什么这样做呢？
Because the works...
因为人所做的工
is the basic way for us to connect and relate to each other.
是一个非常基本的方式，让我们可以彼此有一个重叠。
Actually, it's not bad. It's not bad.
其实不是不好的哦。
But we cannot stop there.
但是这不应该是停止的终点。
Because one day we will retire from our job.
因为有一天我们会离开我们的工作。
We don't do the job anymore.
我们不再做那个工作了。
Oh, we are more than we have five skill set. This is only one skill set that you're describing. That's not really me. I am more than what I do.
其实我们很可能我们有的技能其实远多于我们所做的那一份工作，所以我们对人的认识不能够只停在那个工作的抬头。
Our true self is much deeper than what we do.
我们真正的自己是远多于我们所做的事情。
So Jesus said, if you cannot handle what I told you about I'm the way, the truth and life, let's start with what I do.
所以这耶稣跟他的门徒说，如果你不能够明白什么叫我是道路、真理、生命，那就从我所做的事情开始。
So Paul in Acts chapter 9.
所以保罗在使徒行传第九章
ask, who are you, Lord?
问说主你是谁？
And what shall I do for you?
接下来就说我该为你做什么？
He wants to know who.
他要知道谁。
Then he wants to know what to do.
他接下来要说要做什么。
He got it right in the right sequence.
他问的是一个对的顺序。
But a lot of time.
但很多的时候。
The way we relate to each other and to Jesus is the opposite.
很多的时候，我们跟神的关系或彼此的关系是相反的。
We start with the do first.
我们开始先知道他做什么。
Then we work our way into the who are you, Lord, kind of question.
我们才会问说神你是谁。
Actually, most of us don't even ask that question anymore after we become Christian. We stop asking. We ask the question before we become Christian. Then we become born again, and then we stop asking that question anymore because we already have Jesus.
事实上，对所有的耶稣基督徒来讲，这是一个挑战。因为当我们重生之后，我们就不再问主你是谁这个关键的问题。
Well, we have to keep asking that question, Who are you, Lord?
我们需要一直不断地问这个问题，主你是谁？
In fact,
事实上，
Isaiah 6,
以赛亚书第六章，
verse 1 to 9 show us,
一到九节告诉我们，
that these three questions, who are you, Lord?
这三个问题说，第一个，主你是谁？
Who am I in you?
第二个问题是，我在你里面是谁？
What shall I do in light with who I am in you?
第三件事情是，当我明白我在你里面是谁之后，我该做什么？
Are three most fundamental questions we need to use to dialogue and grow deeper in knowing Jesus forever.
这是三个问题，我们可以用来持续我们跟神的对话，以至于我们加深对他的认识。
I imagine myself transitioning from my earthly life into eternal life.
我试着想象，我把我在地上的生活转换到天上的生活，永生。
I will continue to use these three questions even after I entered into eternal life to grow in the knowledge of Jesus.
我个人定义要持续用这三个问题，一直到永生，以至于能增加我对神的认识。
On that time, during that time, there will be no more evangelism.
在那时候到的时候，不再有这个传福音的一个机会。
Because everybody who is saved have eternal life. I mean, it's done, right?
因为大家都已经得救了，有永生了。
And there's no more healing ministry.
不再有医治的事工。
Okay? But there's because nobody is sick, right?
也没有人生病。
But we will still love.
但是我们还是会爱。
We will still grow in the knowledge of Jesus.
我们还会持续增加我们对神的认识。
And we will discover who we are.
我们会更多的发现我们是谁。
Because you are the faithful witness, therefore I'm eternally a faithful witness to witness about who you are forever. Wow.
Who's faith witness?
Jesus is the faithful witness in Revelation 1:5.
启示录第一章第五节，耶稣是那个忠实的见证人。
Because he's a faithful witness and I'm made in his own image, so I'm a faithful witness.
因为他是个忠实的见证人，而我是因他的形象造的，所以我也是那个忠实的见证人。
Therefore, even now, I should not bear false witnesses.
因此，我现在不做假见证。
Because it's Ten Commandments.
因为这是十诫之一。
It's not because it's Ten Commandments. It's because I am in the image of Christ. He's a faithful witness. Therefore, I am a faithful witness.
撇下十诫不说，因为我是照他的形象造的，所以他是忠实的见证人，我就是。
And now I will be his faithful witness even till death.
Death.
Death. 为他做见证，直到死亡也为他做见证。
Thank you.
Yes.I think I wasn't very clear. So, anyway, so what I'm saying that I am is based on who he is. That's my identity. It's not because I'm an engineer, I'm a preacher, I'm a musician. Those are my job. That's not my identity.
所以我是什么？这个重点的关键是在于因着他，不是因为我所做的工作。
Your job can change.
你会换工作。
I'm a mom, but one day your children grow up. You say, you're still mom, but your children don't need you exactly the way when they need you when they're young. So you transition from mom into less mom.
当你是母亲，作为一个母亲的做例子来说，孩子小的时候很依赖你，孩子长大不太依赖你，你还是个妈。
Everybody have to go through that transition.
我们每一个都要过这个的转换。
I'm going through the dad into small dad right now.
我从一个好像什么都是存在重要的父亲，变成一个好像不是那么重要的父亲。
Actually, still important. I just don't feel it so much anymore. Yes.
还是很重要啦，只是说我没有感觉到那么多就是。
So everybody goes through that transition, but that's not my identity.
每一个人都会经过这样的角色的转换。
My identity is rooted in who he is.
但是我个人的身份不是这些关系，不是这些工作，而是跟着他有关。
And that is eternally secure.
而那个神给我们的是一个永生可以定装的自我的认识。
So what do we do?
所以我们该做什么事？
I'm going to take the next 10-15 minutes, bring it to conclusion.
接下来花10到15分钟做个结论。
I'm looking at the clock, this is a real one, okay?
我在看实际的时钟。
Because we don't have eternal time yet, yeah?
我们在这里还是时间有限，还不是永生。
I will keep preaching, because...The 144 description of Jesus in the book of Revelation.
因为在这个启示录里面有关于有114个描述，我会一个一个讲，时间不够用。
I think over 10 years ago, they asked me to preach on the book of Revelation. I tried Revelation chapter 1 just on description of Jesus. We tried for 1 week, almost 6 sessions a day. I cannot finish chapter 1.
在十多年前。我曾经尝试过一个礼拜一天讲六堂课都讲不完启示录第一章。
So actually I wrote in the abbreviated form a devotional called Jesus 360 in Chinese, translated into Chinese, available in the bookstore in Taiwan. You know, I don't know how you get it, but it's basically listing all the beauty of Jesus in the book of Revelation.
事实上我有一本书就是叫360度的读圣经，在台湾的书房有出售。
So I encourage people, if you get hold of that book, read it very, very slowly. One description, 1 week.
如果你有那本书，一个礼拜读一个关于耶稣的描述就可以。
Slowly digest and talk to Jesus around that description. Like Jesus, you are my faithful witness. You're the faithful witness. You can go for a whole week and live your life around Jesus. You are the faithful witness.
就像一个礼拜一个描述，就像说耶稣，你是一个这么忠实的一个见证人。这个礼拜可以咀嚼一星期。
And because you are the faithful witness, therefore I am your faithful witness.
因为你是那个忠实的见证人，所以我也是那个忠实的见证人。这都是印证。
Therefore,
When the Holy Spirit come upon me in Acts chapter 1 verse 8.
所以因此当你的灵在如同使徒行传一章八节里降临的时候，
I shall be your witnesses in Jerusalem, in Judea, in Samaria to the ends of the earth.
我要成为在耶路撒冷犹太全地到直到地极做你的见证。
So what shall I do?
所以我该做什么呢？
I will not stop testifying about you.
我不会停止为你做见证。
Because I'm a faithful witness.
因为我是一个忠实的见证人。
But who said I'm a faithful witness?
但谁说我是个忠实的见证人？
He said so.
因为你说的。
Because he's the faithful witness.
因为神是忠实的见证人。
And I'm made in his image.
而我是照神的形象造的。
Can you imagine every day you just go through that over and over again in your daily life?
你可不可以想象你每一天就在这样子的一个领受当中？
Let's try another one.
我们再试另外一个。
Jesus, you're the one who holds seven stars on your right hand.
耶稣，你是那个右手持七星的。
In your right hand, there is seven stars.
在你的右手有七星。
You know, seven stars, the whole universe is in his hand.
七星，他的整个宇宙就在他手中。
So because you are the one with seven stars on your right hand,
因为你是那个在手上有七星的。
And the seven stars are messengers.
七星是七个使者。
And the seven messengers to the seven churches.
整个七个使者到七个教会。
I am a messenger in one of your churches on the earth.
我就是你在教会地上其中一个教会的使者。
So what shall I do?
所以我该做什么？
I will be your messenger.
我要成为你的使者。
What message do you want me to carry today?
今天你究竟要我传讲什么样的信息？
Who are the people you want me to share with when I meet today?
当我今天与人见面的时候，哪一些人你要我去分享这些信息？
But I'm afraid to share because they will be upset with my message.
但是我很怕，因为我如果讲了，他们会很不高兴。
They don't like the Jesus thing.
他们不喜欢耶稣这件事。
But you are the one who holds the seven stars in your right hand.
但是你是那个手持七星的。
And you came to John and you said, "Do not be afraid."
你到老约翰身边跟他说，你别害怕。
So what should I do?
所以我该说什么
？Hear the voice.
听那个声。
I'm afraid.
我很害怕。
But you say, "Don't be afraid."
他说。
But I'm still afraid.
我还很害怕，别怕。
But you say, "Don't be afraid."
不害怕。
But honestly, God, I'm still a little bit afraid.
但老实说神，我还是有点害怕。
But you speak over me again. Do not be afraid. You hold the seven stars.
但是再说一次，不要害怕，你是手持七星的。
So if God asks you to do something,
所以神要你做一些事。
Oftentimes is an ambush.
常常是一个突袭。
What's an ambush?
突袭是什么意思
？Ambush means there's something that is clear, but then there's something that's hidden.
就是隐而未现。
Something that's clear is that okay. I ask you to go there and do this.
很明显，一种说明白说就是说，来去那里。
And if you are a good Christian and a good disciple, you say, Jesus, I'm willing to obey you.
如果你是一个好的基督徒跟门徒，你就说好，耶稣，我顺服你。
So what shall I do?
所以我该做什么
？How shall I do it?
我该怎么做
？When shall I do it?
什么时候做
？Who shall I do it with?
我应该对谁做？
How much resource do I need to do it?
我需要多少资源？
Can you see all our questions? Do, 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 do.
你看到我们的问题一直是做做做做做。
These are good Christians. Only good Christians ask God before they do.
好基督徒会这样子问哦，一直问，一直问，一直问哦。
The bad Christian, they don't even ask. They just do or don't do, and then ask God to bless it later. You know.
比较不长进的基督徒就不问了，就叫神祝福他。
The good Christian will fast and pray.What shall I do? When shall I do it? How much do I need to do it? Who shall I do it with?
这个一个进城的基督徒会进食祷告，一直问主：我该做什么？跟谁做？什么时候做？怎么做
？I'm confident you are in the category of good Christian.
我相信各位都是那个进城的基督徒
，right?
是吗
？But we're still stuck with the third question. We start with the third question all the time.
但是我们还常常被第三个问题卡住。
So sometimes we get trapped Because when things seems to be going positively in our own measurement, we're like, hallelujah, breakthrough, God is good. When things go negatively according to our own measurement, we're like, oh, God, spiritual warfare, you know, like bad.
我们常常被第三个问题卡住，就在于我们用我们肉眼所见到的东西来判断事情的进展。事情进展一切顺利的时候，我们荣耀感谢荣耀归给主；当事情不顺利的时候，我们是在属灵的征战当中。
Our emotion go up, go down, go up, go down. That's normal. That's human.
所以我们的情绪就像一般正常人一样，有上有下。
Our happiness depends on our success metrics.
我们的快乐是完全看于我们怎么样评断成功。
Whether we are accepted or we are rejected.
我们完全看我们是被接纳还是被拒绝。
Because we are focusing on the doing realm.
因为我们的重点就在做那件事情。
But we forgot in John 14, Jesus said the doing is a doorway to escort us into the knowing.
我们忘记了在约翰14章提的一个重点，做的这个重点本身是带着我们去认识神，是问神，以至于我们可以更认识他。
Jesus said, if you cannot accept I'm the way, the truth and life, the way I say it, start with my works, but don't stop with my works, that's the doorway.
所以回到我们刚才说的约翰福音在提的14章的事情， 耶稣为什么会来要叫门徒跟他讲看我所做的功，是因为门徒不明白 我是道路、真理、生命这件事情。
So when God gives us some work to do,
所以当神告诉我们做什么事的时候，
His most important purpose is not just finishing the job, but that we get to know Him more in the job.
所以我们明白，当我们受差遣做事情的时候，那个重点不在于事情的本身，而是能够真的更多的认识神。
And not only that we get to know Him more in the job, but we get to know ourselves and be more secure in who we are in the job.
所以当我们在做这样的过程当中，不单单我们可以更多的认识神，我们有机会更多的认识我们自己。
So we have to keep asking the three questions.
所以我们必须一直持续地问这三个问题。
Who are you, Lord, in this assignment?
主啊， 在这个事情上面你是谁？ 在这件事情上面你要怎么彰显你是谁？
What are you trying to show me about me in this assignment?
在这个事情上你要透过这个事情彰显我是谁？
So fast and pray.
禁食祷告。
Seek God for how to do it, who to do it with, when to do it.
禁食祷告，求神告诉我们怎么做，如何做，什么时候做。
But don't stop there.
不要停在那里。
Don't forget to ask the question, who are you, Lord?
不要忘记问主你是谁。
You know, I have to clarify, I have not been functioning as a CEO of IHOP for a few months now.
我要澄清一下哈，我已经不当这个IHOP的CEO呢几个月了。
I'm still part of IHOP leadership, but I've functioned for 12 years, but I have transitioned in my role. That's not my identity. That's actually a good illustration.
这是一个很好的例子，就拿我个人来说，我在 IHOP 当 CEO 做了12年，但是我现在转换到一个新的角色。
CEO come and go, but I'm still Daniel.
我有没有 CEO 的 title？ 我还是 Daniel.
I'm Daniel the beloved.
我是被主爱的 Daniel.
The angel came and said, "Daniel, oh greatly beloved, that never change."
天使会来跟我说，那个被爱的 Daniel， 这个不会改变。
For 12 years, I could be CEO. For the next 12 years, I could be a children pastor.
12年我做了CEO, 可能下12年我可能当孩童牧师。
Who knows?
谁知道呢?
But that doesn't change. I'm Daniel, oh greatly beloved. I'm still the greatly beloved.
但是我还是非常确定我是那个主所爱的Daniel。
And you relate to me, not just because I'm a CEO, because I'm Daniel.
你跟我的关系不是因为 希望你跟我的关系不是因为我是CEO， 而是因为我是Daniel。
So, this is a great illustration, actually.
这是一个很好的例子来说。
Because I have been functioning in CEO role for so long, it has almost fused into my personality.
因为我做CEO 做了这么久，好像人已经搞不清楚我跟这个CEO的关系。
When I look at things, I immediately go into my CEO mode, you know, very, very quick. Solve problem.
fast.
我这个 CEO 的这个解决问题的这个变成我的天然的能力，很快
creative solution all the time.
很快就要找问题找答案。
So one time,
有一次
because I have these three questions that is guiding my own discipleship, my journey of growing in knowing Jesus forever.
因为我用这三个问题来带领我一直寻求永远的认识耶稣。
There's this problem that I need to solve.
有一个我要解决的问题。
The problem came in front of me.
有一个问题到我的面前，我需要解决。
I prayed and immediately during my prayer, I know what to do.
就在祷告当中，我立刻就知道该怎么做。
Step one, step two, step three. If this happens with this possibility, go this way. If this doesn't happen, go that way. Three other possibility. Worst case scenario, do this. You know, like all this stuff. It's all clear. It came to me. I said, God, thank you for your solution.
作为一个训练有素高品质的 CEO， 我立刻就解出一个图像，怎么解决问题的图像，各个步骤各个可能发生情况很清楚。我说感谢神。
You can call that anointing or something, but it happened a lot. So I, what happened to the battery? Running out of battery? Is it the way like when you preach over time, the battery just go dead in this church?
It's not the case.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just kidding. All right. So, What I was saying was that I had the solution clearly in my mind. All I have to do is implement the solution.
就回到刚才祷告那个例子，在祷告当中，我很清楚地得到该怎么做，所以我唯一需要的就是什么？实行。
So, I asked the three questions.
我就问这三个问题。
So I said, God, if I were to do it this way, I think I can solve the problem, but I...do not actually know who you are, why this problem came to me, and the opportunity to know you deeper in this problem. I don't know what you're trying to reveal yourself, the part about you. I want to know you.
所以我开始运用这个问题，在那个事情上，虽然我知道该怎么做，但是我问神说，神啊，但是我不知道为什么这个问题会发生，而你要在这个过程当中要让我认识到什么样的东西，关于你的，或是关于我的。
And then I'm also in charge of the timing because I start implementing, and then the next step, I'm controlling the process. But what if I put this one on hold and say, God, you start the process, then I respond, though I know what you're trying to show me.
因为我作为一个 CEO， 我一样负责执行的时间点。所以我也可以选择这个事情，把这个时间交在神的手上，神你亲自开始起始的工作。
可能更准确的就是说，我想讲的就是我在控制这整个过程的时机，就是说我其实要做就可以做，可是我失去了认识神的机会，所以我跟神说，神啊，不然你做一个，你走第一步，我就知道那个时机到了没有。那你就给我知道说从我第二步怎样走，我可以用那个计划，可是你先开始第一步。 You start with the first step. So I actually waited for 2 months until my efficiency tolerance was like really I love efficiency. Yeah, when something is not efficient, I pull my hair. So, okay.
所以你知道对我来讲要把这个起始的时间交在神的手上，在这个例子当中，我因此等了2个月，这对我来讲是很难受的，因为对我来讲，我一直追求效率的。
How long more, Lord? How do I even know this is your first step? Like, you know, I keep talking to him. Like,
我一直跟神说，主啊，还要等多久？
Well,
我怎么知道？
I can wait because the problem is there, but if I prolong it, the problem is not going to hurt or damage more things. Because that's.
但这个有一个前提啊。这个问题在那边，它不会拖延本身，好像不会造成立刻对人的伤害或迫害，这是有一个前提的。
That's amazing translation there. Yeah.
Thank you.
I can't even. Yeah. Thank you. So, one day my FaceTime buzz ring, my phone ring with FaceTime.
我的手机那个 FaceTime 那个 app 响了。有一天。
Strange number.
有一个不认识的号码。
I don't know who is the phone. Usually I don't want to answer. I just felt that day I should. So I swipe my phone.
那是一个不认识的号码。平常我不会接这种未知来电，但是那一天我就接了。
And then the other person appear on this other side of the screen say, Who? You call me? No, I didn't call you. You call me. I didn't call you. I don't even know your number.
所以另外一个人说，脸就出来了，说你打电话给我吗？我没有，我没打电话给你，搞不清楚谁打给谁的。
I've been waiting for 2.5 months.
我已经等了两个半月了。
The supernatural thing has God. You are in charge of Verizon phone line. Yeah.
所以神迹终于发生了，主啊，你真是控制 Verizon 的电话线，让这个不知电话可以进来。
Alpha and Omega. God is revealing Himself in such a remarkable way to me, and I was saying, I remember I laughed for 3 days nonstop. I was so buzzing, God, if you're going to lead like this, I can do this all day long, like every day. I can serve you all the days of my life. Just keep doing this.
Okay. 好兴奋，好兴奋！这个事情之后，我连续大笑了三天，都非常非常喜乐。说主啊，如果你要一直这样超自然的带领我的话，我可以一生每天都这样做。
The person who called me is the key person to solve that problem.
因为打电话给我的那个人，我们连上的那个人是解决这个事情的关键人物。
And the person didn't even call me. He said he didn't call me.
但那个人说他没打电话给我。
Okay, so that's one story. The other one is even more amazing.
还有一个更精彩的故事。
I try to do it in 3 minutes.
我试着在三分钟结束。
So some of you may have met my son, 19-year-old boy.
有些人可能遇过我19岁的一个儿子。
And he's a little precocious, which means he's a little fast.
他事实上比较快。
Yeah. So when he was 17, he's about to graduate from college. So the senior year, he said, "Dad, I want to do PhD."
他17岁就要从大学毕业，所以他跟爸爸说：“
so,
爸爸，我想念博士。”
And I have no way to know how to guide him. It's way above my pay grade.
但这个东西超过我的经验跟能力，所以我不知道该怎么带领他。
So、and then he wants to study in the field that when he mentioned, I don't even understand what that field is like.I don't know what you're talking about. Explain to me.
他甚至跟我提他想主修的一个科系、主修领域，我根本不知道该怎么解释。
After learning for 2-3 months, I understood enough what field he was trying to study.
终于两三个月的研读之后，我开始明白他想读什么。
Actually related to the pandemic now, but that time there was no pandemic, so you know.
这是跟一些生化、医疗有关的一些行业。
So anyway, at that time I said, God.This, I don't know how to guide him. I don't know the process or application, where to go, how to go. I don't know how to do this.
所以我把这个带到神的面前说啊，我真的不知道该怎么帮他忙，因为我也不知道下一步该怎么走。
See, my conversation with Jesus still doing. I don't know how to do this. I don't know how to do this. Still doing, right? I'm a good Christian, but I'm still trapped, right?
你看到在我自己跟神的对话当中，你有没有看到我一直在问神该怎么做，该怎么做，该怎么做
？Hopefully, I'm a good Christian, but I'm still trapped with the doing question.
我希望我是一个好基督徒，但是我仍然被卡住，做什么，做什么，做什么
？So I have to remind myself to ask, "Who are you, Lord, in this?"
所以我需要提醒我自己说，主啊，你是谁
？What are you trying to show me who you are in this? He's giving me a very big challenge right now, and I want you to reveal yourself.Who you are, and then who I am, and what shall I do in that sequence?
在这件事情上，你究竟要怎么样的彰显你是谁，以至于我是谁，以至于我该怎么做
？To cut the story short, I went to Hong Kong and preached in a conference that was before the pandemic, and then I came back. There was a young man visiting from Boston who wanted to see me.
事实上，长话短说，我去香港布道。回到美国之后，有一个从波士顿飞来的年轻人来找我。
So I said I have some time. I would like to meet you because a lot of people are talking good things about you.
我就跟他说，这个年轻人说，我想跟你碰面，因为很多人对你有很好的称赞。
Oh, actually, one of them is coming this Saturday. Pastor Ed Hackett is coming here, and Ed Hackett told me you got to meet this young man. Excellent.
其实，其中给一个大力推荐，这个其中的一个年轻人是 Pastor Ed Hacker， 这个礼拜也会来。
Well, he is a faculty of Harvard, and he got PhD from Harvard and Cambridge. I was like, what?
他是剑桥、哈佛的博士兼哈佛的教授。
He's only 36 years old.
他现在才36岁。
Say what? 36 years old and faculty of Harvard, and then graduated from UK and.How did he do all these things and still be 36 years old? I don't know.
我们不知道怎么他36岁可以从剑桥毕业，然后成为哈佛的老师，才36岁怎么做
？You know, I come from Kansas City. Maybe in Bay Area, this is normal, right?
你知道，对我从 Kansas City 来讲，这个不太正常。也许你们是正常的。
We don't have people who graduate from Cambridge and Harvard that show up every day, okay?
我们不是常常有这种哈佛跟剑桥毕业的学生。
So, So the young man sat in front of me. He's talking about Jesus for 30 minutes. How he make decision, how he loved Jesus. I was like, how can this person love Jesus so much in that kind of environment? That's not possible. It's so challenging.
这个年轻的哈佛教授跟我花了30分钟谈耶稣的事情，谈他如何来耶稣。我心里在纳闷，怎么可能在那个环境他会这样子爱耶稣？
And then in his testimony, he said a few things, and I calculated in my brain very quickly. He started his breakthrough at 17 years old.
就在他讲述他的见证的过程当中，我很快的计算，我发现他的突破点在17岁。
And I remember my son is 17 right now.
我现在想起我儿子也是17岁。
Maybe this meeting is not for me. This meeting is for my son.
也许这个会议不是我，应该是我儿子。
Better text him, ask him to show up.
赶快叫我儿子过来。
You know, when you have a 17-year-old, they will ask you, why do I have to come?
17岁的孩子会问爸爸说，我为什么要来？
Is your meeting? Who do you want me to see? You know?
你到底要我见谁？
Not 11 years old, they will come, but 17 years old, they have their own thinking, right?
11岁的孩子很乖，你 text 他就来。17岁不是这样。
That day he was in good mood, he never asked why.
那一天他心情很好，我一 text 他就来了。
He never asked me to prove myself why I need to use his time.
他不需要我跟他证明为什么我要浪费他宝贵的时间。
He just show up in 5-10 minutes. He just show up.
五到十分钟他就出现。
I say to that person, and are you willing to have coffee with my son for 15 minutes? I think something, two of you go talk, you know, something might happen.
所以我跟这个年轻的教授说，你可不可以跟我儿子花10-15分钟？也许你们可以聊一聊。
He was so kind and humble. He went and have coffee with my 17-year-old boy.And then that night, I checked with my son. What did he say?
所以这个年轻的教授非常谦卑，也非常仁慈。跟我儿子谈了之后，那天晚上我问我儿子到底发生了什么事，他说了什么
？Well, he said, you know, your youth is your advantage. You're not too young to do your PhD, you know. And he shared his own experience, and he said he will write recommendation for me and help me in the whole process.
他以他个人的经验告诉我儿子说，他可以帮我儿子写推荐信。你并不会太年轻做念博士，我会帮你写推荐信。
I say, what did he just say? He's going to help you in the whole process. You mean like your father don't need to know anything?
我很惊讶，问我儿子说，他真的会整个过程带着你，而我做父亲不需要做任何事吗
？Then, okay, this young man's name has the last name of Lim, exactly the same way.
这个年轻教授的。姓也是是 Lim， 跟我是一样。
And the strange thing you know is Lim is not Taiwanese, it's not mainland Chinese, it's not Hong Kong because it's either Lin, Lam or something else. Lim has to come from my part of the world.
你知道 Lim 这个翻法不是台湾大陆啊，或者是香港的中国人啊，这是从另外。
But the same Chinese character, you know that.
但是同一个姓双木林。
Then.I Google him because he's so complicated. I try to explain to my son his background, and then I found his Chinese name.
所以我就 Google 这个年轻的教授，就找到他的中文名字。
Spell in English.
用英文拼。
And then it sounded like my son's name.
他英文念起来就跟我儿子的名字是一样的。
So we look up Google and type the Chinese character, and I text it to him, and I say.Brother, is this your full name in Chinese? Ling something something.
所以我就查了之后，把这个中文名字 text 给这个年轻的教授说，你的中文名字是这样子吗
？I send my son's name to him.
我又把我儿子的中文名字寄给他。
No, I type the 3 Chinese character of my son's name to him, not his name, my son's name.
我把我儿子的中文名字寄给他。
He said, Pastor, how do you know my name?
这个年轻的教授跟我说：“你怎么知道我的中文名字
？”They have the exact same name in Chinese, same character.
他们的中文名字三个字都是完全一样的。
That young man grew up in United Kingdom.
那个年轻的教授是在英国长大的。
And then God transplanted him to Boston.
然后到了波士顿。
He became faculty for 12 years.
他成为哈佛的教授12年了。
And then he drive through Kansas City, fell in love with the prayer room, decided to move to Kansas City at the month my son want to apply for PhD, and they have the same name.
你可以想象这事情的奇迹吗？开车从波士顿经过 Kansas City， 他因着受到祷告式的吸引，他留下来，就在那一天 就遇见了我儿子，在我那个月，我儿子要申请 PhD program.
I can do this all day long if you keep doing this. You take 20 years to prepare a person and drop him in front of me when I have no answer.
我跟主说，主啊，我可以时时刻刻一生都要做这样的事情。你预备的这个年轻人二十年的时间，就在那一个月，我儿子要申请博士的时候，你把他带到我们中间
来。Because you want to reveal yourself as El Shaddai, the Almighty God.
因为你要彰显你自己是那个全能神。
That you can do all things, and because you can do all things, I can do all things through Christ who strengthened me.
因为你可以行各样的事情，以至于我也可以行各样的事情，是透过耶稣基督。
Well, the rest is history.
其他的就是过去的历史了。
I again laugh for 3 days non-stop.
我又开怀笑了三天。
I'm just like, God, this is amazing. I can do this all day long.
我跟神说，这实在是太奇妙了。
I can just be a donkey all day long and serve you, and it will work.
我可以成为一只驴子。就是每天的服侍你。
Thank you, Jesus.
感谢神，感谢耶稣。
Eternal life begins now.
永生从现在开始。
Begins on the day you were born again.
在我们重生的那一天开始。
But we have to grow in the knowledge of Jesus.
但是我们需要越来越多的认识耶稣。
How do we keep growing every day in our daily job?
我们怎么样在每天的规律生活当中增加我们对耶稣的认识
？In our daily struggle，
在我们每天的挣扎当中
；In our daily challenges，
在我们每天的挑战当中
；In our daily suffering for some of us，
在我们每天的受苦当中。
Some of you say suffering. Why have you got so much suffering？
有些人在苦难当中，你会问主：为什么我要受苦
？Don't just ask why so much suffering. Ask who are you, Lord？
不要只是问。为什么有这些苦难
？In this experience of the cross，
要问在这个经历当中，主你是谁
？Who am I in you？
而我在你里面是谁
？Through this experience of the cross，
透过这个经历这个苦难，回答这两个问题。
Then what shall I do？
然后第三个问题是，那接下来我该做什么
？He can remove the thorn in the flesh. He can remove the suffering.
他可以移除所有我们的苦痛。
But sometimes he allows some things to happen in our life.
但是有些时候，神允许这些事情发生在我们的生命。
Let's respond to the Lord in prayer.
我们用祷告来回应神。
Indeed, God wants to love us forever.
是的，神要永远的爱我们。
All the time in the whole universe is not enough for Him to love us.
全世界的宇宙的时间都不够用，让他们来让他爱我们。
All the time in the world is not enough for him to be with us.
全世界的时间都不够用，让他来与我们在一起。
He likes us that much.
他是如此的爱我们。
So this evening, I just want to invite you.
今天晚上我要邀请各位。
Whether you are in this room,
不管你是在这里实体的。
Or you are following and listening online.
或是线上的。
I want you to open up your hearts.
我要你把你心打开来。
And ask the Lord to give you a fresh love to discover and to know Him.
求神给你一个新鲜的爱，来那个爱来认识他。
That to use this simple step revealed in Isaiah 6 and John 14 to grow in the knowledge of Jesus.
用在以赛亚书第六章兼约翰福音第十四章提的这些步骤来增加我们对神的认识。
And if you want to go beyond just the doing,
如果你要不只停留在做的上面
，I want to invite you either to stand up where you all come forward and respond to the Lord.
我要邀请你从座位上站起来，或是到前面来回应神。
Don't wait for one another. We're going to conclude this service very soon.
不需要等别人，我们很快要结束。
Those of you who are online, just stretch out your hands when we pray together.
当你在线上，如果你在线上，把你的手举起来。
I'm going to begin to pray for those online first.
我要先为线上的弟兄姐妹祷告。
I want to invite Marie and the team to join me to minister and pray for these who are responding to the Lord.
我们请我们的 iHub 的弟兄姐妹前面来为弟兄祝福祷告。
Thank you, Jesus.
感谢耶稣。
Thank you, Father.
感谢父神。
I want to pray for my brother. I just felt the Spirit of God stirring me to pray for my brother.
感谢神，我要为我的弟兄先来祷告，圣灵搅动我。
I just sense the mantle of discipleship.
我感觉有一个带领，一个门训。
God is giving you a new measure of grace to make disciples.
神要真是要给我一个完很大的一个带领门徒门训的一个点。
A fresh confidence to make disciple.
一个很新鲜的一个信心来带领。
It's not how much you know and how much you do not know.
不在于我知道什么，我不知道什么。
But is your heart posture?In pursuing him that the Lord sees.
而是我的心是这样子的意思在寻求神。
And I pray for you, my dear brother.
我为我亲爱的弟兄来祷告。
That you will give him much grace to multiply.
你会有许多的恩典以至于你可以倍增。
Let him be fruitful.
让那多产倍增。
Let him multiply.
多产倍增。
In Jesus' name.
奉耶稣的名。
Lord, I pray for those online.
主啊，我为线上的弟兄姐妹祷告。
Lord, I pray, God, wherever they are at,
不管他们在哪里
escort them into an Isaiah 6 reality.
把他们带到以赛亚书第六章的一个真实当中
Open up the veil, let them see beyond the veil.
打开那个帐幕，让他们看见后面
Remove the things that hinder them from seeing you face to face.
挪去那一切拦阻他们跟你面对面的障碍。
If there are offense, if there are offense or bitterness that is hindering them, remove it right now.
也是由他们因着个人的痛苦，以至于他们没有办法真的见到你。
Father, I pray in the name of Jesus.
主啊，以奉耶稣基督的名祷告。
I just sense that God want to give breakthrough in the area of forgiveness.
神也要在这边给一个突破，那个突破是一个与饶恕的突破。
There seems to be an issue of unforgiving that's holding some people back from the doorway of the revelation of God.
有一些人因着不能够饶恕，以至于没有办法真的认识神。
If you identify with that wherever you are in this room or online, I want to encourage you to go to the cross right now.
如果那是你，不管你在实体还是线上，我要你现在到十字架面前。
And then you just surrender the person that offend you to the Lord.
你把你冒犯你那个人带到十字架的面前交给主。
And you just say, God, I don't feel like forgiving, but I am forgiving right now. I am forgiving this person. I'm surrendering this person.Through the cross,
你说主，我不想原谅，但是我愿意在你面前降服，把他带到了你面前，要饶恕他。
And I sense that a lot of these unforgiving hindrances were due to betrayal.
许许多多，我认识，我感觉到这些所谓的不能够原谅的背后，有一个背叛。
你被别人背叛，到你没有办法饶恕那个背叛你的人，今天放下。放下，把这个人放下，宽恕在神的十字架面前。神给你一个突破，给你可以进入更认识他的心的一个状态。Father, we just thank you.
主，我们谢谢你。
We thank you.
我们谢谢你。
Do this deep work today.
做更深的工作。
Hallelujah, 感谢主。
谢谢你做更深的工作。
I'm going to go down and pray for people.
我接下来为弟兄姐妹祷告。
I'll hand the time to the worship leader.
把时间交给敬拜团队。
是。 耶稣。